All right, so the next exercise is weight taping. So we'll do the yellow one. You guys are up here, so you may as well go. As they're getting organized, and you might want to, like, you keep it and you read. Okay. As they're getting organized, let's go around and guess what this horse weighs. We're going to start with you. And you can do it as partners.
1250?
I hear a 1250.
Sure, it's a guess.
Okay, what do you guys think?
1125.
Oh, 1125, all right.
I was going to say more like 1300. Yeah.
1300, okay. Oh, did somebody else say 1300? Yeah. You can do 1301.
Okay, well,
yeah, because it's Price is Right rules, right? Okay, so how do you guys want to do this? Knowing what you have is a like a seamstress tape, measuring tape. What do you want to do with it?
Go kind of around, just behind the shoulder, kind of where the grip would go.
Okay, so take that measurement.
Should I go on the other side? You can match the two
ends. I love these guys. So what we're going to help them do, we're going to help them make sure that this heart girth measurement is perpendicular to the ground. Someone the other day measured their horse, and this was quite crooked. And it changes the measurement substantially. I will also warn you, because one of your assignments after this is to go practice these things. Goodness. Some horses don't like this. So be very careful, especially with you have a handler and two and a person on each side. The horse really has nowhere to go except over the top of one of you. So try not to throw the measuring tape around. Does she hear me? Amy? Yeah. So when you guys are doing this, just be a little bit, you know, more, think of it as like a wild Mustang. Yeah. And then this is really good placement. So it's at the base of the withers, not on the withers. And it's called heart girth because it's back, it's where your girth goes. So the rule of thumb is, for most people, is it's a hand's width from the leg, right? So that's good. And then your tension is you're holding it tight, but not so hard. Hold it tighter so we can see the difference. Yeah, so now he has muffin tops, muffin creases, right? We're depressing the flesh. So that's too tight. So then loosen it up a little bit. Perfect. All right, so what do you get for a number?
79.
Write that down. Let's go with 79, because that's, yeah, 79. What's the other measurement you want to do? Right, okay, so you get to pick one. Since you're on this side, I pick a shoulder. Make her do the butt.
Okay.
So Amy, you can come on this side now.
I'm going to drop this.
So where are they attaching, where are they holding the front of it? The point of the shoulder. What did you say? If you go middle of the chest to middle of the tail, that's more like measuring for a blanket. That's like the three-dimensional volume of the horse. We just want how long the horse is. So we're going to go from the point of the shoulder to the point of the buttock. I'm going to come help you back here. The point of the buttock is more like here. That's the longest point. But we also want this to be parallel to the ground. So you two kind of got to work together. You're a little higher, you're a little lower, and it's got to be taut, but not like, no muscles. Yeah. So then once you two are happy, you give us a number.
I'm showing 67.
Okay. So now who's got the formula? Carolyn.
It's 1200.
Oh, you did the math already? Yeah. Can you walk us through it just so we know what you did?
I did 79 times 79.
Because heart girth times heart girth.
Times, I think it's about 67.
My phone
divided by 330.
Thank you. And you got?
1,267.
So 1,267 pounds. All right. When we did it the other day, and it's always going to be a little different. So whether you're using that tape or the commercial tapes that Carolyn's going to hand out next, it's important that the same person do this, the same horse, the same way. So these numbers aren't really absolute as much as relative. Do you know what I mean by that? It's consistency and it's measuring again and again. Because when we did it before, we got 1229. Right. So what were your guesses on estimates of weight?
1250.
Oh. You guys, yeah. You guys get ice cream too. Okay. So if you went, it's price story rule. So if you went over, right, then you lose. Okay. So you guys are done. Carolyn, can you hand the SmartPak tape to someone? Okay. Who wants it? Who wants it? Going once. Perfect. So now this is a commercial weight tape. That tape is in inches. What's this tape in? Pounds. It's already, the formula is built into the tape. I feel heavy breathing. Is it him? Is it him? Okay.
He's self-conscious about his weight.
And he from Tuesday to Thursday, right? So same deal. Base of the withers, perpendicular to the ground, snug but no muffin tops. It can't be twisted.
We're good.
So it would be the bottom of it?
Where this one meets this one. Where this one meets, yeah.
So it's 12. 1260.
That's pretty cool. Yeah, because what do we get with the other one?
1267.
Yeah, so 1260. Right. You keep, hold on to that.
Okay.
Where's the other weight tape? All right, who wants to try this one? This is a different company.
Only one?
Yeah, that's fine. So same deal. Base of the withers, perpendicular, not twisted, snug but not tight. And then not scaring him with it or another horse in the new vicinity. Okay. What I want you guys to see from this is that different tapes are going to have different values. And it's okay. You just keep using, don't switch tapes. You got to pick a tape and stick with it. Which do you think is more accurate? These kind of commercial weight tapes or the yellow one that Amy and those guys had? I'm going with the yellow one because it's taken into account not just their barrel circumference, but their length, right? Because I have a horse that's super, super long. He's like 80-something. It's crazy. Yeah.
Not doing this right?
Yeah.
Like off the weight tape here.
Yeah, so you have to extrapolate a little bit. You, not you. So each of these chunks, we figured out 1130 to 1160 pounds, right? Each, like, here. So you're coming down to just the end of the 1310.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. We could call him 1310. So this one's got him weighing like 50 pounds more. By the way, how much does each body condition score number translate to in pounds? So I can hear people say, oh, my horse needs to gain 100 pounds or lose 200 pounds. And my brain translates that to body condition scores. So what are your guesses? Well, the answer is 50 pounds. But to me, when it's a horse like this that's over the average 1,000-pound horse, I kind of go, maybe it's closer to 75 pounds.